Hi, this is Rishabh. Today I am going to show you how to sketch, to draw the difficult sketches. These are the sketches which have been used in the industries. The very interface of a CATIA V5 R20. As you are already well known of this, there are many options that we can choose right now. There are many commands. Now, what I am going to do is tell you how exactly we should proceed and make a complicated structure. This particular structure has an applications in many of the industries. I am going to demonstrate how exactly we should proceed while making the sketch on the CATIA. First and the foremost thing that we need to do is centralize all the commands into the default places. That we can do by customizing all the by customizing and reset the position that they were before. In this interface, currently what you are seeing is there is an axis shown at the center. On the leftmost side, there is a naming of all the axes that we have to use. At last, there is a part body that we are going to create later. And there is UCS icon at the rightmost corner. So now I will introduce you with the sketch that we are going to try for 2 days activity. This is the very sketch. It has complicated structure which includes dimensions as well as angles which are inclined to certain degree. There are horizontal lines, vertical lines. Together it makes a plate which we need to extrude till 5 mm. Setting all the commands into their default position, this will give us the exact area where we should exactly pick up the commands which are most required at the particular moment. This is the particular thing that every design engineer should know before doing any project. After observing the diagram, we must come into a conclusion from where we should start the origin so that it can take the dimensions exactly from where we want. Let's take another look of the diagram so that it will get imprinted in our mind. So it will help us getting the rough diagram without the dimension at very first place. The next step, what it comes is selection of an axis. Here they have given only one dimension, and that is the front view. Now we have to consider which axis should give us the front view. So we must consider the plane XY plane, because this resembles the exact front view of a diagram. From where, after exiting, we can do the pad command so that it will show the exact component that we are going to use. After getting inside the plane, we are going to get the axis system. These axis, it will show X and Y. It doesn't show exactly the X and Y axis, but it will denoted as horizontal axis and vertical axis. That we should get to know from our knowledge. As I told you before, that we need to fix a point from where we are going to start drawing the sketch. After we've gone through the diagram, finally I have come into a conclusion that I will going to take from the leftmost corner there. I am going to use it as an origin from where I will draw the rough diagram without the dimension specifically. I am going to select the draw command. As I have told you that we need to start drawing the diagram from the origin itself. The coordinate for that origin will be 0, 0. I have already drawn the sketch before, so I will just show you how I have done. So this is the one. We don't need this exactly. I will delete it. This example I have took just to show you that we need a pivot point that should start from the origin. I have clicked that pivot point, as you can notice. If at all that pivot point is not coinciding with the origin, then we have to take the option that is from the constraint. The constraint is nothing but where the degrees of freedom will get restricted for any component. It will do simply coincide, it will get into origin. Hopefully, I guess you have understood what I am trying to tell you exactly. Now we'll switch back to drawing our component, which is shown in our diagram. As I've told you, I'm going to start from the origin itself, and I'm going to take a rough diagram. That diagram itself is imprinted in my mind, so I'm going to make it a little bit quicker. So just follow me. It's not very perfect, I guess, but somehow we can adjust it later. by adjusting, because none of the lines are perfectly aligned, I guess. So I have to see it again, and then I have to recompile it as per the given diagram. So there you can see that it is taking default the alignation of the point, which is none other than useless things. We can also drag and manipulate as how we want. This particular line, we need it straight, so we can take from the constraint option. So now it is like perfectly done. So this gives the rough diagram of what we want. Now the next thing what we need to do is taking the dimension for each component that we have drawn. Just double click on the dimension, then select the each line one by one. It will give you the dimension. Now we are not adjusting all the dimension. First, just we'll try to make the component fully constrained. What is the point behind fully constrained diagram is it will show whole diagram into a green section. If at all it shows the red, then somewhere the figure is not closed, or it has been open somewhere, or the dimension is not satisfied for that particular diagram. While giving dimension, we need to consider the all the dimension, that is length, and respectively the degree of alignation. That also we need to specify, otherwise this diagram won't get fully constrained. So far we have done, now it's fully constrained. I have to arrange all the length and dimension exactly as what it is given in our diagram. I have done almost like it's not perfect exactly. It's been done now. So after finishing all our diagram, the next very step that is that we need to use the pad command, extrude command. Now here in diagram they have given 5 mm that we need to extrude it. So I'm giving it at as a 5. Just do the preview and see the section how it is done. It's perfect. So this is what we need to make a plate exactly. So this is it for this part of the project. We are going to head towards the next project that we are going to see. It is a bit simpler, but I'm going to use the other commands, not just the extrude command. Well, let's just see. All steps are similar like what we have done before. Just the thing is that the sketch is a little bit different, but it's too easy than the previous one. Let's get jump to the sketch directly and we'll consider the dimensions what they have given. Here the thing is that we have to revolve the sketch whatever we'll get at the end point. Same thing, select the plane, go to the sketch command, then start drawing the sketch as per the given drawing. Consider all the dimensions what they have given. Now first we'll just draw the rough diagram. It is simple, but application wise it will be a little bit difficult. So let's just see. Here what I have included extra is like there are some other applications of the commands later on after when we will do the revolving part. Finally the exact demonstration of the sketch has been done. The rest what the part left is we need to do the dimensioning of each component. We need to be precise with whatever dimensions that we are given, because if at all there will be a mismatch in the dimension, then one zero here and there, the whole diagram will get spoiled. I have to refer back the sketch as I have to see it, whether I'm going wrong in some directions. If the geometry is same, then later on we can change the dimension as we want. I will take it little slow because there is an elevation and also there are angles somewhere. If we go wrong with this, then the V notch, which is at the bottom, it won't be proper as it has to be in the sketch. Considering the fact that this sketch is going to get revolved on one axis, I have taken the pivot point that is from the extreme right position. It seems like it's all done from here. Now the very next step that I'm going to do is just adjust a little bit dimensions here and there. Well, it should look nice little. All part is done. Yeah, done everywhere. Just cross check if it is left out somewhere. Now exit the sketch. This is the sketch that we wanted. Do the revolve. We have to do the revolve till 180 degree as per the given drawing requirement. So we have to consider the axis now from where we need to revolve it. So as when we give the axis, it will automatically take 360 as a default, but we need to set it to 180. This is done. How nice does it look from the sketch to the real part, how it like. This is all for my tutorial. Hope you have liked it and enjoyed what I have done. I tried to tell you all the aspects which are there in the CATIA and you might have got to know how we should use the commands properly. Don't forget to like and subscribe my channel if you are new on this channel. So see you until next time.